rise to oppose the bill, which was moved by Sri Jitendra Singh Ji, as the proposed amendments weaken the very basic tenets of the institution of right to information. It looks like the government wants to control the term of office, the salaries, the allowances, and other terms and conditions of service of the Chief Information Commissioner, the state CIOs, the Information Commissioners, and the State Information Commissioners. The government can then make them dance according to their own tune because they will not be able to function independently, sir. Sir, the second point, after the Modi 2.0 government has assumed office, it has passed as many as 11 bills without any legislative scrutiny of sending to standing committee. Brute majority, madam, does not mean that you should act brutally. This is unfair to democracy, and I would like to advise the government to desist from brutal force. I would also like to bring to the notice of this August House and to Sri Jitendra Singh Ji that he is going to be bringing amendments also to the CVC Act and to the Lokpal Act, because it says so in paragraph 4 of the Statement of Objects and Reasons in the bill copy that the functions being carried out by the Election Commission of India and the Central and State Information Commissions are totally different. The Election Commission is a constitutional body. On the other hand, the Central Information Commission and the State Information Commissions are statutory bodies established under the provisions of the Right to Information Act 2005. Therefore, the mandate of the Election Commission of India and the Central and State Information Commissions are different. Hence, their status and service conditions need to be rationalized, is the statement in the bill itself in paragraph 4. So I think this shows that what we can expect is coming forward is that even the CVC Act and the Lokpal Act on the same justification will be amendments will probably be brought, is what I'm anticipating and asking the House to be aware of. If this is the justification being used by the government to take the CIC into their hands through this bill, the government can also use the same justification, as I said, to amend the CVC Act and the Lokpal Act, as they are also not constitutional bodies. Do we want to accept this justification, which will dilute the independence of all of these important bodies, is the question we need to ask ourselves. The final point, and relating to the information being provided, or rather not being provided or being denied under the right to information. Madam, the term record in the RTI Act is defined, but the Act does not define what constitutes a classified record. And the government has been denying information under the RTI, citing it as classified. So I request the Honorable Minister to define what is classified and what is not classified, so the citizens of this country know what is their rightful, what can they rightfully demand from RTI and what they can't. Today it's ambiguous, and the government has to clear that ambiguity. So I request to send the bill to the Standing Committee and to withdraw the bill as it dilutes the RTI Act.